Thank you so very much. Our God is faithful. Mungu wetu ni mwaminifu, anainua kwa viwango. Sante sana, our brother Simon. God continue giving more deeper revelation, even as you continue singing and even producing songs to the glory of God. May the Lord continue to anoint you. Now we want to hear the word of God. I'm so grateful that you are tuning in. Thank you, Pastor Faith, for tuning in. My wife, thank you so very much, Nelly, Mamake Anita, for tuning in. Thank you so very much, Jennifer, for tuning in as we hear the word of God tonight. I'm so grateful to have you online. Thank you so very much, Anne Mwende, for tuning in tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you so very much, Elizabeth, all the way from United Emirates. Thank you so very much, Gloria Sheila, for tuning in tonight as we hear the word of God. Thank you so very much, Cecilia, Mamake Ezra. Wonderful to see you online and on board. Thank you so very much, Samuel Morillo, for tuning in tonight as we hear the word of God. Thank you so very much, my dear mom, Hannah. I'm so grateful that you have tuned in as we hear the word of God. Thank you, Simon. I see you are on. You are on your songs. Many people are asking of your songs. They want the songs that I always play before I preach. I've directed them to the YouTube. They are even blessing many people. Glory to God. Now, I want us to go to the word of God, and the Lord shall bless us. Just a few minutes. I request over you a few minutes, and the Lord shall, and this word shall not leave you the same. There is power. Every time you hear the word of God, something changes. And faith is built up in you, because faith comes by hearing, and by hearing of the word of God. Therefore, as you go to hear the word of God on your few minutes, I am sure this one will not leave us the same. Father, I want to thank you for this moment, even as we share your word together with every viewer. I ask you, Lord, to open our hearing, open our understanding, and I pray that you give me the tongue of the learned, that I will speak your only will to the glory of your name. May you dispatch and release your power for transformation, for even a healing, for deliverance, upliftment, encouragement to the glory of your name. I thank you for your presence. May you minister to us through this platform in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say amen. Now, don't get used to the word of God. I want to read a very common scripture that you know. But I know, after this word, something good is going to happen to your life. I'm talking about turning your dry bones into giants. Turning your dry bones into mighty giants, mighty warriors. Hallelujah. And we are reading from the book of Ezekiel 37. The Bible says, "The hand of the Lord was upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me back and forth among them, and I saw a great many bones on that floor of the valley." I saw many bones on the floor of the valley. And the Bible insists and says the bones were very dry. He asked me, "Son of man, can these dry bones live?" Now, we can continue reading and reading, but I want us to bring to your attention that it is possible for even the most driest bones to come back to life and to become a mighty army, to become great giant for achieving exploits. How can this be? The Bible begins by saying, "The Spirit of the Lord was upon me," was upon Ezekiel. You see, there is nothing that is too hard for God to change. Nothing that is too hard for God to turn around. This God has been tested and proved. The presence of the Spirit of God and the hand of God brings all the difference and is able to turn around every matter and every circumstance. The Bible begins by saying, "The hand of the Lord was upon me." and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord. This time and this season around, if there is anything we desire, we need to desire, is that the hand of God be upon us. Because when the hand of God is upon you, there is no situation that cannot change. There is no condition that cannot change. There is no circumstance that cannot change when the hand of God is upon you. The hand of God makes all the difference. When the hand of God is upon you, there is no door that can withstand and remain shut. There is no hindrance that can withstand your presence and hinder your progress. When the hand of God is upon you, it makes all the difference. And the hand of God is the game changer. The hand of God is the game, the transformer. It is the transformer, the changer, which causes metamorphosis, which brings life where there is death. Glory to God. The Bible says the hand of the Lord was upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord, and he set me in the middle of the valley. The hand of God will lead you to your rightful place when it's upon your life. When things are happening in the today's life, whatever is happening and surrounding our nation and nations of the world, what we need is the hand of God. And let me tell you, provided the hand of God is upon you, doesn't matter where you find yourself being, doesn't matter the condition you find yourself surrounding you. As I talk right now, there could be many things and many situations that seem like dry bones. And the Bible says the bones were very dry. We are living at a time when many people are right now are in a valley of dry bones. Dry bones depicts and stands for hopelessness, stands for discouragement, stands for place where there is no future, where you have come to the end of yourself. Dry bones seems lifelessness. Glory to God. And the hand of God can lead you anywhere. The hand of God can lead you to the mountain, can lead you to the valley, especially when God wants to manifest himself. He can take you to any place, any position. And one thing I know is that before God clothes you, the hand of God will lead you to a place of nakedness, so that now he may come and clothe you, and that his glory may go back to him. Before God feeds you, the hand of God will lead you to a place of hunger, so that when he comes, you will say, for sure, this is the only God can do miracle. You know, there is that miracle which is an only God can do. A miracle that, in quote, only God can do miracle. Glory to God. He leads you to a place where he makes you worthless, so that he may come and make you worthy. Before God promotes or lifts you up, he takes the hand of God, takes you down. Before God fills you, he makes you empty, so that he may come and fill you. Glory to God. So the hand of God will lead you to a place of which seems to be a place of hopelessness, a place which seems to be so dry, a place which seems to be a place of no progress, a place which now you lift up your hand and say, only God can take me out of this situation. You could be in such a time at a place. That is why this word is coming to us today. Because as I talk right now, even many believers have been put in such a place. Christians have been put in such a place. Citizens have been put in such a place where businesses have gone down, where many have lost their jobs, where many have got no salaries anymore, or even reduced wages, where many are just in a place which is only God can do place. Hallelujah. A place where you don't know, you are saying only God can help me. And this is a place where Ezekiel was taken. A place which was full of dry bones. Today, as I speak to you, I know the circumstances that are surrounding you, the conditions that are surrounding you. Imagine even the church, because the Bible says, when you go to verse 11, the Bible says, then he said to me, son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say, our bones are dried up and our hope is gone. We are cut off. This one I'm speaking tonight, that I know somebody is saying in their heart, we are cut off. Our bones, our hope is gone. We are cut off. Our bones are dried up. Our hope is gone and we are cut off. Perhaps you have been cut off from your progress. You have been cut off from your project. Even as a church, we have been cut off from gathering together. We know every one of us, and it is unless those lukewarm Christians who are not missing what we used to do before. But personally, and every, I know even you are missing that time when we gather together, that time when we worship together. Oh yes, if you can happen to speak out, you say you miss those times of koinonia, that times of fellowship together. What we are doing now is not, is just an extension, just something to, you know, supplement. Our Bishop JB says this is meeting halfway, ili kukutana nusu. That's how we are meeting now online. It is halfway. I cannot give you a high five. I cannot shake your hand. I cannot hug you, you know. And we have been cut off. But I have. The good news is this thing is here to pass. This thing is here to manifest, to turn around even weaklings to become mighty giants in the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to believe these people, these bones, while people are dying, the way they came back is not the way they were dying. They came back divine honor, divine power, divine strength, divine wisdom, divine understanding, revelation after revelation, greater doors, greater strength, because it was now at that which has been rejuvenated by God. Because the Bible says that those were very dry, and these were the house of Israel. This was like the church. It was like you and me. The bones were very dry, and the people of Israel were saying, our hope is cut off, and we are very dry, and we have been cut off. I have got good news for you. No matter how much you have been cut off, Jehovah is going to restore. This is a season of restoration. There will be mighty restoration in churches. There will be mighty revival. Oh, just wait and see what the Lord is gonna do in the physical, because already in the spirit it is happening. Let me tell you, the enemy has been given a knockout by now. If what the enemy intended has gone through, by now things would be otherwise. By now we would be talking of other things. If the plan of the enemy never backfired, if the church never prayed, by now it would be other things. But this one has caught the enemy by surprise. The enemy never thought that it will happen the way it is happening now. When you see nations opening up, when you see other countries, children beginning to go back to school, when you see other countries beginning to lift up lockdowns, and so on and so forth, understand that the Lord has given victory. Let me tell you, no matter how much the devil is trying to resist, we are getting there where God intended us to get. I am saying we are getting there. We are still praying. No scheme of the devil shall revive. Everything will keep on backfiring. Because as a church, we have been cut off. Imagine, we have been silenced. We cannot gather. We cannot worship like before. But the devil is a liar. We are getting back to a place where God needs us to get. So what has been destroyed in your life, it is possible to come back as a mighty giant. Because the Bible says, God himself asked Ezekiel, he said, son of man, can these bones live? It was a hard question, depending, because considering how situations were. It's like asking you, shall you get to a place again of rejoicing? Shall you get to a place again of having more than enough? Shall you get to a place again of, you know, living a life full of how you used to live? Let me tell you, it's gonna be better. God Almighty is turning every dry bone to become a mighty giant. I thank God because of what Ezekiel said. Ezekiel said, oh, sovereign Lord, you alone know. Then he said to me, prophesy. I want to tell you, by these actions, every dry bone shall turn to become a mighty giant. Doesn't matter how hopeless the situation seems to be. Doesn't matter how hard the situation seems to be. Doesn't matter the kind of news we are receiving every day. Because of course, you know, in this nation and many media houses, even outside this nation, good news, bad news is good, is news. But good news is not much news as per se. If I normally say, if a dog bites a man, it's not news at all. But if a man bites a dog, that's news. So right now, there's too much market. There's a good market for media. Because every time we are hearing this news, they are so busy now reporting of infections after infections. And we are going to go higher in those reports. But let me tell you, God remains to be supreme. we have the safety of the Lord in this nation and the nations of the world. Whatever the enemy schemes plant, it's gonna backfire, has backfired, because dry bones are coming back to life. Oh, hallelujah. The church is coming back to life. Nations are coming back to life. I want to believe this time around, many people will give their life to Christ. Continue in prayer. Make sure every week you have a day of prayer and fasting. Continue connecting yourself to the Lord. Because God told Ezekiel, prophesy to these bones and say to them, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says to these bones. Prophesy. Tell these dry bones. Tell this situation that are so hard. Prophesy to the impossible situation, to every impossibility, and say to them, hear the word of the Lord. So this season around, when things seem to be so dry, so hard, finances so hard, resources so hard, project to, you know, so hard, everything seems to be so hard, prophesy and speak the word of God. In other words, know the word of God over your situation. Know the word of God over your dry bones. Know the word of God over your circumstance. I believe there is no situation that has no answer in the Bible. Every situation and condition has a word, divine word from the Lord. There is a word for every circumstance which you encounter in your life. So what we need to know is, what is the Lord saying pertaining this situation? What is the Lord saying pertaining that circumstance in your family, that condition in your business? What is the Lord saying pertaining whatever you are going through? Know, get to know what God is saying. Because the worst thing is if you don't know what God is saying pertaining every part, every situation. Ezekiel had to know, what is the word of the Lord? What is the Lord saying concerning these dry bones? So God said to him, prophesy to these dry bones and tell the dry bones, this is what the sovereign Lord says to you. Now, what is the Lord saying concerning your situation? What is the Lord saying concerning your impossibility? What is the Lord saying concerning your desert? What is the Lord saying concerning your battle? What is the Lord saying concerning your challenge? That thing that you expected very much and it never materialized. What is the Lord saying concerning that situation? What is the Lord saying concerning you being jobless or being fired from your workplace? What is the Lord saying concerning your condition? The problem is, many of us have no idea what is the word of the Lord concerning their situation, concerning their circumstance. They have no idea. And that's the worst thing, the greatest tragedy, to fail to know what is the will of God concerning everything that is you are going through. He said, prophesy to these dry bones and say to them, hear the word of the Lord. There is no way he could have said, hear the word of the Lord, not knowing what God is saying concerning it. What is the Lord saying concerning your children, your spouse? Oh, yes. What is the Lord saying concerning our situation as a nation, such a time as now? May prophets arise and give direction them all. This is the greatest prophecy, is the word of God. So he said, hear the word of the Lord. This is what the Lord is saying. And the Lord said, told him, prophesy. This is the time. Don't give in, don't give up on your dry bones. Don't give in, don't give up on your impossibility, on your hard circumstances. Don't keep quiet. You better talk with the heavens or the earth. You must speak and say something, because somebody said, if you can say it, then you can see it. Let me tell you, you can never experience what you don't expect. And if you can believe it, then it will be easy for you to speak it. Because when you know what God is saying about your situation, then you believe it, then you will find yourself speaking about it. Glory to God. Because there is power in the spoken word. Because the Bible says the tongue carries the life or death, and it is the one that directs or amplifies or vibrates the word from the voice box. So we've got to speak it, because some areas you can't keep quiet. Jesus himself said, if you have faith, if you believe you have faith, you will speak to this mountain and say to it, be it thrown to the sea, and it will go. So some things you have got to speak, you have got to prophesy. You have got to declare things. Job 22:28 says, and we shall declare a thing, it shall be established. So we have got to speak, and it will hear. Like what David did. The enemy knew that for me to finish this boy David is to threaten him with voice, with words, with the things that I'm gonna say. Am I a dog that you come against me with a javelin, a sword, and a spear? This day I'm finishing you. And David spoke back and he said, Today, I will cut off your head and I will give your body to the birds of the air. There are so many Goliaths that are speaking to us now, but we've got to speak back. Speak back to your situation. Don't speak about your situation anymore, but speak to your situation. Speak to your giant. Speak to your dry bones. Prophesy to them. Keep prophesying. If it doesn't happen the first time, don't give up. Don't give in. Keep prophesying. It will finally respond. What happened to Elijah when he had sent his servant to go and look at the sea to see whether there is some cloud forming? The servant came 7 times telling Elijah nothing yet, but Elijah never gave up. Many Christians give up on the first trial, the second, the third, and because God is not coming through, they say, this is gonna not work. But let me tell you, your giant can rise again and become a, your dry bones can rise again and become a mighty army. Great giants. What happened when Jesus was praying for this blind man? He prayed for him the first time and he asked him, can you see? He said, oh, I see, but I can see people like trees. That was the master of the universe. That was Jesus. How can you dare give up? Don't you ever give up. Whatever you hear being announced, whatever is encountering your life, whatever is challenging your family, challenge the challenger before the challenger finishes you. Listen, speak to your giant. Speak to your mountain. Oh, hallelujah. Speak it around. Speak it while asleep in your bed. Keep speaking like a madman. Speak while walking. Speak while working. Speak it. Let it hear. You cannot afford to die like your grandfather. You cannot afford to die useless man like your forefather grandmother. Declare in the name of Jesus, you refuse. What Jesus is, so shall you become. As he is, so shall we be. Let us prophesy things. Let us declare things. Lay hands on your children and prophesy to them. Declare you are becoming mighty in the Lord. Declare to your business. Declare to your situations. Prophesy. God said to Ezekiel, prophesy to these dry bones. God himself had the ability. But he told Ezekiel, you prophesy. Speak to your mountain. Speak to your dry bones. And the Bible says that they began coming together. Oh, hallelujah. When he prophesied, God said, I will put my spirit in you and you will live. Oh, glory to God. We need to do like Jesus did to Lazarus. When he went to Lazarus, he said, Lazarus. And Lazarus in the grave said, yes, sir. Come forth. And Lazarus said, yes, sir. He came forth because Jesus prophesied life. You can prophesy to your situation. Every dead situation can come back to life. Every weakling can become strong. The Bible says that the poor say they are rich. Let the weak say, we are strong. Let the sick say, we are healed. In other words, prophesy. Paul said, I believe, therefore I spoke. We have got to speak what we believe, what we see. Prophesy to your future. Remember, you cannot delete your history, but you can write your destiny. God has given us an open check to fill it. He has given us an open paper to write our future. You cannot change your history, but you can determine your future. I say you can determine where you are going. Refuse to remain there and speak it out. The four lepers said, we are going to the camp of the Arameans. If they spare us, they spare us. Let's go anyhow. Today, begin speaking. Oh, begin prophesying to yourself. Prophesy to your shadow. Prophesy to your life. Prophesy to your business. Prophesy to your children. Prophesy. Say to these dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Know the word of the Lord concerning your situation. And declare to every situation, it will hear. My life is as a result of prophetic word. I prophesy upon myself. The greatest prophet of yourself, of your destiny, is yourself. The greatest prophet of you is yourself. Prophesy over yourself. Oh, Rimazekata. Declare things in the name of Jesus. My business will work. My family will stand. My children will prosper. Oh, yes, my parents will live long. Prophesy. Speak life. and the Lord will release life unto every situation. I pray for you today. May every dry bone in your life turn to become a mighty giant. May every dry bone in your life turn to become a mighty army. In the mighty name of Jesus, let things begin to change until people will wonder, what is the secret? There is no much secret. The secret is knowing the word of God concerning your situation and begin speaking that word until it becomes. Speak the word until it becomes. Until it becomes flesh. Jesus was incarnated. The word became flesh and dwelt among us. You can speak this word until it becomes flesh. Until it forms itself. The same word which was spoken in the book of Genesis. It is still as powerful in your mouth as it is in the mouth of God. Speak it until your situation changes. Speak it until your family changes. Prophesy until your circumstance changes. Prophesy. Oh, you are the greatest prophet of yourself. You carry the spirit of a prophecy, a prophet. You can prophesy, if not to others, to yourself and to your siblings and to your work and to your job and to your future. Declare, I will not die poor. I will not die a sufferer, neither a hustler. Oh, glory to God. You can be a different person by what you speak. What you begin speaking now, 5 years to come, I tell you it will be manifesting. Oh, you are living a result of what you spoke 5 years ago. That is what is happening now. Refuse to shut up your mouth. Let you shape your destiny by your mouth. David shaped his destiny by his mouth. He said today, I will cut off. It was faith. I'm telling you, he didn't have armory. He didn't have guns. It was just by faith. God had not even shown him how he will cut off the head. But by faith he spoke. By faith he speak it. Speak it every day. It will come to pass. Glory to God. I'm so grateful. May God turn your dry bones to become mighty giants, to conquer every territory. In the mighty name of Jesus. Nothing is too hard. Nothing is irrelevant when God is involved. I'm so grateful for all of you tuning in tonight. Thank you so very much. May the Lord bless you. I don't know who I had not mentioned here. Carol, thank you so very much. God bless you in a tremendous manner. Pastor Virginia, may God turn your dry bones into become giants in the name of Jesus. Terry, B. Ukebi, may God turn your dry bones into mighty giants in the name of Jesus. Servant of God, Pastor Michael, Reverend Michael, let it happen in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Oh, Sheila Holly, let it happen. Let me tell you the truth. What a simple man can do with the Spirit of God can never be done by mighty men. The Spirit of God in the heart of man is something more than gold. It will turn around every circumstance. He will turn around your situation. And this is the season of the Holy Ghost. Something new is about to happen. Are you ready? Glory to God. I want to pray for you tonight if you're not born again. And the Lord will save your life. This is the high time. You cannot afford to stay without Christ. Because Jesus is the answer. Say, Lord Jesus, I love you tonight. I come to you. And I give you my life. I ask you to save me. Cleanse me by your blood. And make me whole. I thank you, Jesus, for your saving grace. Now I am born again. Amen. I want to pray for every one of you. May the Lord turn your dry bones to become giants. The Bible says these people became a mighty army. Because if you read here, the Bible says that the skin covered them. They became... I will make breath in you and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. If you read the next, the last scripture here, it is saying the people received the Spirit of God, flesh came upon them, and they became a mighty army. That's how your situation will be. That's how your business, your life, your future, everything that seems to be dead will be as you continue pursuing the Lord, the Spirit of God, the presence of God in obedience. You are not going to die a shameful death. You live long until you are satisfied. Yes, you will not live a life of shame anymore. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for every viewer. I ask you to turn around every situation. Every dry bone, let them be turned by your divine power to become mighty giants, a testimony that they will know you are the Lord. I bless them tonight in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the Lord bless you, keep you, and prosper you. I love you. I value you. I'm so grateful that you tuned in tonight and you have heard the word of God. May this word become reality in your life. In Jesus' name. Love you. Peace of God.